And this is, in a sense, wrapping up here my comment, and I'm going to say it now anyway. I know you have one more question, but, you know, we've been talking here for an hour about some horror. But this, to the audience, is why the three of us keep talking about the importance of the rapture, because the rapture removes us from the horror to come. This is why we're passionate about the topic of the rapture. And it's my complete bewilderment why the church is silent on the best news there is today. There's a very little good news today. Yeah. Very, very, very little good news today. The best news today is the rapture, because it keeps us from this wrath. It keeps us from this time of devastation, dissension, disease, disasters, death, and delusion. It's the rapture. So, audience, forgive us if we keep talking about it. In our radio, in our meetings, in our conferences, we're going to keep talking about it. It's the best news there is.
Well, this is the relationship to the last question. And I know we're going to go over a little bit, so bear with me, folks. But this one, it would be criminal for me not to ask. And I know I couldn't cover all the questions, folks. I really apologize, but we only have so much time. Here is the question. And this is open to just a brief insight is all we're asking for. Will Christians who don't believe in the rapture be raptured?
Absolutely.
You see the point? If I don't believe in the rapture and I'm a believer, will I be raptured?
You'll be shocked, but you will.
Yes. What's happening to me? Okay, Amir or Barry, what do you say about that?
Yeah, I always say if you don't believe in the rapture, you're in for a very pleasant surprise.
A quick surprise at that.
In a moment of twinkling of an eye, you'll be supernaturally translated into the presence of the Lord in a glorified state. But we have to remember, it's not belief in the rapture, your position in eschatology, that saves you. Right. It's the blood of Jesus that saves you. And that alone is what's required for salvation. Yes. And, you know, all these interpretations and multiple positions and all that causes division in the body is just that. It's division. It's something that... it doesn't replace the gospel message of Jesus. You know, as Amir alluded to Acts 4:12 earlier, there's no other name under heaven by which you can be saved. That's it. That's the whole message of the gospel. Jesus saves, not your eschatological position.
True. And I would say this,